Okay, so the entire idea about this, Zoa, is that you wanted to tell people how you're feeling basically in quarantine and how you're doing. So you want to just go ahead and just tell people, when was the first time you felt the symptom that you had got coronavirus?
I think it started with a fever around 20th March. Very mild fever, and I was just feeling a little bit of weakness. But actually, my sister got fever before that. She was feverish a day before me. And then the day after that, suddenly we checked my fever and even I had fever. But initially, first 2 days, it wasn't much at all, just a little bit weakness and the fever. After the third and the fourth day, this cough started. A very strange kind of a cough. So then it was getting scary because you keep reading everything online and, you know, it was kind of matching what, like, it was the symptoms had started matching. But still, it wasn't that bad until I think it reached the sixth or seventh day when I started feeling it in my chest. Like, the cough was becoming more intense. Like, you feel, it's not like you can't handle it. You can handle it. It's like a normal cough, but it just feels weird in the chest that, oh, I'm getting an infection, something's wrong. It's like that.
So it wasn't something like the first day it happened to you when you knew ki I'm unwell, mujhe kuch bimari.
Yeah,
it wasn't like that.
No, it was like a gradual, slowly. And I think only after 5 or 6 days it went into this where I was feeling like I can't taste my food when I'm eating the food.
You lost taste. That's on the 5th day.
Yeah, that was the symptom, I guess, because I guess the cold was like inside your system. So it started like hurting in my eyes and I started getting a headache and then the cough. And then I started feeling so tired, like the weakness kind of increased. But we self-medicated at home and took a cough syrup.
So you were quarantined, I believe you were quarantined at home completely when you got back. This is before you felt ill. So you completely quarantined yourself then.
Yeah, so when we realized we have fever, the both of us, my sister and me, we completely isolated ourselves from my parents. My first symptom was fever. Fever and weakness, which followed by a cough, which then followed by the breathlessness and the headache. But then after the 7-8 days, it becomes better. Like you feel better. But I think what helped me maximum is coming to the hospital. Like within 3 days, I feel like I'm totally fine now. I can go home and I think the right thing to do is to come to the hospital immediately and get yourself tested. And it's nothing to be scared about. It just seems like it's a normal flu. Yes, of course, we'll be scared because it's like spread around the entire world and we'll be reading and hearing these crazy stories. But my case wasn't that serious at all. And I'm feeling so relieved after coming to the hospital because I am, from the second day only, I started feeling better in the hospital.
But they did medicate you and that's when you started feeling better, right?
Yeah. The HCQ tablet and vitamin C and all these things.
So the tablet, you do believe that the hydrochloroquine tablet does work? You believe that it did help you a lot in your case?
I suppose, yeah. Because ever since I came to the hospital, I have definitely felt 40 times better. My breathlessness stopped on the second day. I could feel just a little chest congestion and a little fever. But like so much better than what I was at home.
And tell me, diet-wise, what are they giving you or what are they doing in your diet-wise?
Diet-wise, normal. The food is actually really yummy over here.
I feel you're feeling better. You're sounding better to me also right now.
Feeling so good. That's why I really think that coming to the hospital was the best decision ever. Because I feel like I've got cured immediately. And I'm done now, I think, with it.
So what would you suggest people, everyone who's watching this or everyone who's at home, just if you had to give a general message to people, what would it be regarding this illness? That you quarantining yourself and staying at home is a must, we all know that, but how much, what would you just want to tell people, like what should they do?
I think just don't get scared. Like if you start feeling all these symptoms at one go, you probably have it, so just get yourself tested. And start off with it and finish off. I know it's scary, even we felt scared that, oh my god, we're going to get tested. And it's like, you know, you feel scared. But the good thing is, once you start it, you know you can start it, get tested, and then get treated and get out of it immediately. Because I literally have felt so good in just 3 or 4 days.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah, so the thing I would like to say is that just don't feel scared. It's really not a big deal at all. At least for me, I'm thankful that my symptoms weren't very serious. I do know there are a lot of other people out there whose symptoms are probably so much more serious than me. But my symptoms were pretty mild, pretty manageable. And that's why I just quickly got myself tested, got myself treated, and now I'm good to go.
there's a very big difference between your symptoms and Shaza's symptoms. If you could tell us the difference, what is the difference that what happened to Shaza and what happened to you?
So Shaza's headache started first. She started with a headache and fever, she complained. And then her fever and headache continued for 7 days.
Oh.
She had a fever. And then after 7 days, she became okay. The symptoms suddenly just stopped. My symptoms continued, the fever continued, but Shaza had a little pain in her ears. It was as if the cold was probably promoted, right? And then after 7 days, she was also like upping the immunity, everything that's good for her immunity and everything. And she became okay in 7 days. So I still don't know how she tested positive. Maybe it remains in the body for 14 days after.
I guess Shaza completely doesn't have any symptoms. Your dad, Karim uncle, also has no symptoms at the moment.
Zero symptoms. Papa, zero symptoms. And I don't know how Papa got it because we were very careful at home.
You all didn't meet your parents, right?
No, we didn't meet our parents at all.
I want to show you some outdoor since you're here. Oh God, I'm very bad at this. I'm trying to show you some. Kuch to.
So that I feel like
I'm actually trapped in my house. Nothing. No, so, but I'm glad to see. So this IV, why did they give you this IV? You have any ideas, Zoa?
I had a fever, the running fever, continuously for 20 days. And I didn't take any antibiotics till now because we kept thinking that it just like maybe, you know, other things will cure it. But because the fever wasn't going, they started antibiotics. And I think already I'm feeling much better.
After you came, they first gave you the hydrochloroquine and they've given you this right now.
Yeah.
Correct?
From last night they gave it to me, yeah.
So basically it's taken you, you would say around 2 weeks to feel better.
I think at home also when I was like self-medicating, but yeah, it's taken me literally 4 days to feel better over here in the hospital.
Anything that happens to you like in the morning when you get up, how do you feel? Are you still feeling any breathlessness now?
I'm not feeling any breathlessness. In the morning when I wake up, I feel so fresh. There's no fever also. You feel completely normal. I think the only time the symptoms start affecting you is like for me in the afternoon, like around noon. You start feeling
That's great. So, all in all, you're feeling like if you do get to the hospital, a person can start to feel much better if he's there for a week or so.
For sure. Maybe even lesser. Because I started feeling, my breathlessness went the second day that I reached the hospital. Like literally, just clear. And the only thing I was worried about was my little breathlessness. Otherwise, everything else was very manageable.
Any other medication that you are on right now?
No, just I'm on the antibiotic, HCQ and vitamins.
That's it.
And one more.
Alia is saying get well soon on the comment. Alia, she's saying get well soon, Zoa.
Thank you.
A lot of people are sending in lots of love to Zoa right now. Lots. There was Mandana was over here. You know her also, I think. She said that Zoa is talking about chai. A lot of people sending so much love and so much get well soon support to you.
This Priyal is my first life.
Priyal is asking you how long till you get home.
Hopefully tomorrow or day after. Because I'm feeling so good. I'm feeling fine.
A lot of people from Jamnabai sending a lot of support to you.
So sweet.
But I'm thankful really that someone from Manikji is actually doing this for you and not from Jamnabai.
Oh, Ankit.
Me? Ankit, the boss. So just so people know who are watching this, that Zoa and me are pretty much childhood friends. We know each other since, I think, 10 years. And it's like, you know what I said is that till it doesn't happen to someone you know, you don't actually know the gravity of the situation. We don't know how serious this is. And you were telling me last time, you were messaging me that I can't believe it's happened to me.
I really can't believe because I was on the news and I was glued listening to all the stories and hearing it. And then to suddenly realize that you only have it, it is a little scary. But I promise once you go through it, you just realize that, oh, that was completely manageable. It's nothing to be scared about. It really feels like a normal flu. I think people must be feeling more sick with other kind of diseases and stuff. You feel more sick. But I had some days where I was feeling completely normal. You just like to have a little cough and a cold. That's it.
So everyone who's watching you right now, if you have to give one message to all the people, all the citizens of our country, what would you want to tell them?
That don't panic. If you feel the symptoms, just go get yourself tested, go to a doctor and get yourself treated. And you, I think you can just get out of it as soon as possible.
And there's the main thing, I think, would be to stay at home and isolate and just quarantine anyway as safety.
Yeah, oh, that for sure. Staying at home, keeping your distance, social distancing, washing your hands, keeping the immunity up. Those things help massively. Like, I remember having vitamin drinks at home and immediately I would feel good and my energy levels would go up. Even with the thing inside of me.
Okay guys, so now we are going to let Zoa rest. I think the main important message that she said, that she went to the hospital, she felt better. So doctors ki jai ho, to all the doctors, all the policemen, all the watchmen, all the grocery sellers, everyone out there who's doing their job, thank you so much. With folded hands, thank you, because they're curing friends of mine, they're curing you, you're a friend of mine. I think we are all in this together, and Zoa, you're going to be better. I'm very sure you're going to be back home soon, quarantined safely, and everyone sending you so much love online. It's great. If please help them. Help them get to the hospital. लोगों की मदद कीजिए. Don't create a stigma कि अगर किसी को कोरोना वायरस हुए तो आप भाग जाए उनसे, क्योंकि ये आपके किसी आस पड़ोस फैमिली मेंबर के साथ भी हो सकता है. So we are all in this as humanity together. कोरोना वायरस कोई भेदभाव नहीं करता है. Because we were all also shocked when we realized that you got it. So right now the whole thing is everyone sending you strength, gas. With this disease, and you're a big inspiration, I think, to everyone. So, darne ki koi baat nahi hai. We're all in this together.